this place that God loves the earth and the people, and it's about time that the humans got a break.
Well, see,
I
think it's all part of the game. I think, and then this is my opinion, but of course, you know, I think that they're going to come very hostile. People are going to be afraid of them. They're going to wreak havoc, and then they're going to leave. I don't think they're going anywhere. They just have the other ones come in and play the good guys. Now, we're seeing a bad cop, good cop scenario. Okay, so now all the bad guys are gone. Now the good guys are here. Now that's really the Messiah here with all his angelic hosts. I think it's all a game.
Well, we'll find out.
Yeah, well, hopefully, you know. Yeah, I just see it all as a huge game, because when the Lord says it's going to be nothing but death and destruction until he comes back, and when he comes back with the second coming of Christ, he's coming with judgment and destruction. He's not coming to bring peace.
Oh, I don't want to hear that, Sherry.
And so we're not looking for any kind of Disneyland, La La Land peace.
Well,
and it's the aliens themselves that want people to believe that, because they want people to believe that the Antichrist is God and he's going to bring a peaceful kingdom on earth. It's all part of their game. It's a part of end time prophecy. It's been foretold for 2,000 years. And it's all coming out to play.
Well, we part company here.
Yeah, and that's okay. That's okay.
That is okay.
You know,
I see the Creator as having some compassion for this poor, I mean, this human race has been buggered and battered by these aliens for years.
And it's not going to end until, you know, almost three-thirds of this planet's population is destroyed, isn't it?
Well, it may, that, you know, there are going to be a lot of people leaving. I will go there. Yes,
so wait, okay, let's get back to this thing, because you said that when the elite leave, okay,
yeah,
this war in Iraq and this coming one in Iran basically is to fill this UFO that they have in the desert with meat, with humans, with carcasses,
yes,
because they feed off of humans.
Yes.
When they leave, when they attempt to leave, they're not going to actually get away.
No. They're going to get out a little ways, and they are going to be brought down.
Okay, how?
I have heard that there's going to be a huge battle. They're going to be in a battle with someone, and they are going to be brought down. They're going to be captured. They're going to be put in a net of their own, because they have got to understand what they have wrought. They have got to be responsible for the pain and agony that they have created here. And I have this whole file I call An Incredible Future, because I am a really optimistic about this, Sherry. But I've heard it from upteen different people that the earth will be healed, that, you know, and I don't know exactly how that's going to play out. You know, maybe it's going to be Christ coming back and healing the earth. I'm not going to say that, but I have heard over and over that this place and the people who survive are going to be uplifted. The net's going to be gone. So they will actually be able to have their own spiritual growth the way the humans were supposed to in the beginning. That's my take on it. And I have a whole series of really positive, all people will be uplifted, that there will be healing, the earth will be healed. So I have a tremendously optimistic view after the mess.
Well, there is going to be great destruction here, the second coming of Christ, where eventually he's going to destroy. This entire earth is going to be destroyed, and then what he's going to do is he's going to reign on earth himself for 1,000 years, and this is what all of these aliens and the Antichrist and Satan, the owl, are trying to mimic ahead of time.
Okay.
Because they want to deceive everyone into believing that when Satan comes as God, he's mimicking the 1,000-year reign that Christ is going to have here, the real one.
Right, okay.
And so he's going to mimic that. And what's happening now is you see all these beast prophets in the churches today, the Benny Hinns, the Kenneth Copelands. They're all going to swing their support for the Antichrist and deceive their congregations into accepting him as God.
Okay.
And so there's a lot of deceptions coming.
Well, I think, you know, you're right about deception. I mean, it's just rampant here. And, you know, people have strong beliefs, and these aliens are masterful at using people's beliefs. I mean, they will play, as I said, that's why when I heard this rapture card being played, I thought, well, I don't know if any people, born-again Christian people, are going to listen to me, but I just...
They don't listen to me. They call me the Antichrist on the pre-trib board.
Well, I'm just telling you what I'm hearing, and I, as I said, I 100 times I encourage people to please try try this for themselves, because I think that you can get a lot of information about things if you have the time and the energy and the interest. You know, if you really want to know what's going on, I would recommend this. I'm a born optimist. I really do think that things are going to turn out beautifully. I just feel that, you know, I'm a champion of the human race now. I think we've been beaten up enough.
Well, I left optimism a while ago, you know, because I left optimism a while ago.
Oh, not me. I'm still a Pollyanna. Even in spite of everything. I have no illusions that this is going to be an easy time. This is not going to be an easy time. I know that they're going to leave a lot of these aliens behind. They're not taking everybody.
See, the big lie is that these aliens are from galaxies and universes millions of miles away and blah, blah, blah. And I've been warning people, they're subterranean. They live right in our own solar system, inhabit our own planets. All of the planets are hollow. All the moons are hollow. They inhabit the hollow places of these planets, and planet Earth is a total hollow place. There's millions of them in planet Earth. And so they're in subterranean Earth and within our solar system. They're not coming from millions and millions of miles away. And that's why there's so many of them here. You know,
Well, they've told me they live underground. They also told me that they own Mars.
Yeah, and they do, because the ancient Martians, that the long necks that we have in our own history,
yeah,
they were from Mars. They were hybrids from Mars.
Okay.
And, and I've seen in the Bible codes where America has many bases on Mars. And I've heard, secondhand, you know, reading through the UFO researching stuff online, that those bases have been taken over by the aliens.
Well, this one particular alien who, I've had a lot of conversations with them. And, you know, as I said, I reverse everything, but he did say, I was told last fall that they were amassing around New York interdimensionally. I was thinking, oh my gosh, there's going to be some kind of another event, you know, like 2011. Well, that never happened, but he said that what happens is they are not visible, but they are in force there. And he said, we own Queens, New York. And then another one at one point said, you know, we own Mars, because I was reversing this man who was talking about monuments on Mars, and they love to listen into all these things, and then sometimes they give their little feedback, you know, like they'll say different things. So they did say that we own Mars. I have heard that they originate in the Orion constellation.
Yeah, the Orion constellation is Satan's seat in the heavenlies. That's where his planet is.
Okay, well, that's what I've heard, yeah.
Yeah.
That's where they originate.
Yeah, so we're on the same page on that one, definitely.
Hey, we're good. All right.
Yeah.
But, you know, again, I give you a lot of credit, you know, for having me on, because, I think we are getting a lot of the same information. So, boy,
right.
I just want people to really, you know, take heed and not be...
Well, if they won't listen to me, maybe they'll listen to you. You know,
I don't know.
And the whole thing is about warning people, waking them up, giving them information.
Yeah.
I'm a watchman. That I'm an announcer. I'm his messenger. That's what my biggest job to do, besides leading his people back to him, is waking them up, preparing them for the things that are coming ahead. And I do that in very many ways. Let's talk about the chemtrails for a little bit, because I have seen this in the codes where this is not only a Navy and United States Air Force operation funded by the Oval Office. This is also done by aliens.
You know, I have, somebody just sent me a CD by a man by the name of Carnicorn, yes, thank you, about the chemtrails, because they wanted me to do some reversals on that. And as I said, I have my stack here of tapes from people about their dreams and this and that and the other thing, and I'm like, oh, my gosh.
Because I don't think we have the whole story on it, because we know that they're trying to assimilate the atmosphere more towards, move it more towards like a garden.